Very warm good morning children. Already we have completed the exercise as well as the notes for chapter number 4. Today we revise some of the particular questions for chapter number 4 as a revision part. So we are starting with the revision for question and answer. Children, so very first question I am going to ask you people that what do you mean by valency? Agar aisa pucha jayega hai, what do you mean by valency? Find the valency for oxygen. So this is the question for 3 marks if it is going to be there asked in the exam. So valency, how we are going to define that? The combining capacity of an atom. Okay, combining capacity of an atom. Now here we have to find the valency for oxygen. So what we are writing is atomic number Z is equal to 8, that is equal to 8 for oxygen. So here the electronic configuration is 2, 6. That means 2 became stable like neon. It requires 2 more electrons. So it gained 2 electrons. So valency of oxygen is 2. You can find out by this particular way. So that is the very first question for today. That what do you mean by valency and how you are going to find out the valency for oxygen. So you can copy this particular answer. It is going to be there asking 2 marks or 3 marks question. Now next, name the isotope which used in the treatment of cancer. Isotopes are there which are having same atomic number but different atomic mass. हम आइसोटोप उसे बोलेंगे जिसका एटॉमिक नंबर सेम हो बट आइस व्हाट एवर द मास नंबर और एटॉमिक मास इट मे डिफर. तो यहाँ पे पूछा गया कि कौन से आइसोटोप है विच इज देयर यूज इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ कैंसर. सो व्हाट वी आर राइटिंग इज दैट कोबाल्ट, आइसोटोप ऑफ कोबाल्ट इज यूज इन द ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ कैंसर. सो दैट इज अ क्वेश्चन विच यू ऑल्सो कॉपी इन 1 मार्क क्वेश्चन. सो दैट इज अबाउट द particular second question. Now we are moving to the third question, that define isobars. So the elements which have different atomic number but same mass number. ऐसे एलिमेंट्स जिनके एटॉमिक नंबर डिफरेंट हो बट मास नंबर कैसे हो सेम, तो उसे हम बोलेंगे आइसोबार्स. आइसो डेट मीन्स सेम और बार डेट मीन्स वेट. तो जिसका मास सेम हो तो हम बोलेंगे कैल्शियम 20-40 एंड आर्गन 80-40 both are isobars of each other. Here you can see that 20 and 80, that is labeled as Z. Z is equal to atomic number. So atomic number यहाँ पे different है और mass number जहाँ पे अलग हो जाएगा उसे हम बोलेंगे isobars. So that is about what? That is about the particular definition for isobar. Now next, क्वेश्चन नंबर 4 इज दे इफ एलिमेंट एक्स इज हैविंग जेड इज एटॉमिक नंबर इज इक्वल टू 12 देन फाइंड द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन प्रोटॉन एंड न्यूट्रॉन्स ड्रॉ द स्कीमेटिक डायग्राम ऑफ द एलिमेंट क्वेश्चन दिखा है मैंने कि अगर एक एलिमेंट है जिसका एटॉमिक नंबर जेड इज इक्वल टू 12 सो व्हेनेवर यू टॉक अबाउट जेड इज इक्वल टू 12 देन दैट एलिमेंट इज मैग्नीशियम एंड द सिंबल ऑफ मैग्नीशियम इज इक्वल टू कैपिटल एम एंड द प्रोमिनेंट लेटर जी सो हियर नाउ द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फिगरेशन बिफोर स्टार्टिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर आंसर व्हाट वी हैव टू डू इज जेड इज इक्वल टू ई दैट इज इक्वल टू Now distribution of electron K L M N so it is 2 8 2. Now N is equal to A minus P so 24 minus 12 so that is equal to 12. Now we see the schematic diagram for this. So what you are doing sir? First, the very first is nucleus. In nucleus, you have 12 proton and 12 neutron. Now see how many shares you have to draw K, L, and M. That means we are making 3 circles around the nucleus 1, 2, and 3. So first shell is K shell. Shell N is L cell. And third is M cell. So here in K shell we have 2 electrons, 1 and 2. In L cell we have 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 and here again we have 2 electrons. So this is the schematic diagram for magnesium. You know it is going to be asked whether in 2 marks or in 3 marks. So you have idea that how to distribute the electrons. How electrons can we distribute by the rules of Bohr and Mari. The exam paper puchha jata hai that write the rules for distributing the electrons in the particular orbit so that is known as Bohr and Bury rule so Bohr and Bury has both together gave some of the rules which we have to follow that they have said that the electrons are going to be there arranged in the orbitals by using the formula that is known as 2n square where n is equal to energy level now by n jo hai wo hai energy level that means usne bola it is going to be asked in 3 marks n is equal to 1 and then we have K shell. So K shell mein we are just occupying 8 electrons. Then L cell 2 into 3 square that means 18 electrons is going to be occupied. M shell that is 2 into 4 square. So 4 for the 16 to the 32 electrons. And lastly M cell. So 2 into 5 square. 2 into 1 square, 2 square, 3 square and 4 square. So 16 to the left means we have 2, 8, 18 and 32. Sorry for the mistake. So that means according to Bohr and Bury rule, we can accommodate only 2 electrons in K shell. Then what both of the particular scientists have suggested, that electrons are going to be filled in the stepwise manner. That means ki K shell mein sabse pehle electron jayenge 2, uske baad L shell mein jayenge 8. अगर 8 से ज्यादा है देन ओनली दे आर मूविंग टू एम शेल एंड द लास्ट रूल बोथ ऑफ देम दे हैव सेड दैट व्हेनेवर द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर देयर अकोमोडेटिंग इन द वेरी लास्ट ऑर्बिट द नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर ऑलवेज रिमेन इज इक्वल टू 8 दो इट इज 18 बट वी कैन ओनली अकोमोडेट 8 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स सो दैट इज नोन एज बोर एंड बडी रूल चिल्ड्रन इट इज गोइंग टू बी आस्क्ड इन द एग्जाम सो यू कैन राइट इन 3 मार्क्स नाउ नेक्स्ट वी विल टॉक अबाउट दैट व्हाट यू सी अबाउट The discovery of three subatomic particles. So, question पूछा जाएगा that particles. Name the scientist who have discovered them. ठीक है, तो हम क्या लिखेंगे? Three subatomic particles of an atom. That answer में लिखेंगे proton. सबसे पहले लिखते हैं इलेक्ट्रॉन. नाउ इज गोइंग टू बी देयर रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय स्मॉल e. इट वाज गोइंग टू बी डिस्कवर्ड बाय जे जे थॉमसन. चिल्ड्रन यू कैन राइट ओवर हियर, इट इज गोइंग टू बी देयर रिप्रेजेंट डिस्कवर्ड बाय जे जे थॉमसन. नाउ सेकेंड इज प्रोटोन. इट इज गोइंग टू बी रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय स्मॉल e. इट इज देयर डिस्कवर्ड बाय ई गोल्डस्टीन. एंड लास्ट सब एटॉमिक पार्टिकल इज न्यूट्रॉन व्हिच हैज नो चार्ज. स्मॉल एंड इज अ पर्टिकुलर एंड डेंस शेल. अब बात करते हैं विच अमोंग देम कंटेनिंग पॉजिटिव चार्ज. चिल्ड्रन सो यू कैन राइट द आंसर दैट प्रोटॉन इज पॉजिटिवली चार्ज पार्टिकल विच वन इज नेगेटिव. सो आईवी दैट इज इंडिकेटिंग दैट दे आर नेगेटिवली चार्ज, माइनस इंडिकेटिंग नेगेटिव. एंड विच वन इज न्यूट्रल, सो नो चार्ज न्यूट्रल. तो ये तीन मार्क में पूछा जा सकता है विथ 0.5 मार्क कि तीन सबएटॉमिक पार्टिकल्स के नाम बताओ. तो है इलेक्ट्रॉन, प्रोटॉन एंड न्यूट्रॉन. इलेक्ट्रॉन हु हैज डिस्कवर्ड जे जे थॉमसन. देन प्रोटॉन इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय स्मॉल पी. हु हैज डिस्कवर्ड प्रोटॉन, सो यू कैन राइट दैट ई गोल्डस्टीन, अर्नेस्ट गोल्डस्टीन. एंड न्यूट्रॉन स्मॉल एन इट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय एंड इट इज गोइंग टू बी देयर. We can say that James Chadwick has discovered neutron which are containing no charge. So that is all about the subatomic particle, you can write that. Now when the next question is going to be that where all of three are located. So we can say that electron are there located. Location agar pucha jata hai where they are located. So we can write that they are electrons are there outside the nucleus. Proton inside the nucleus and here also inside the nucleus. So it is all about what? It is all about the question 6. Now next is why Rutherford has chosen gold foil not other matter for 7th question. For Rutherford experiment, gold foil is used, was used or is used justified. उसके एक्सपेरिमेंट में खाली गोल्ड फॉइल, दूसरी कोई मैटर यूज नहीं हुई. तो हम आंसर लिखेंगे दैट गोल्ड इज हाईली वैल्यूएबल वेयर एज ही रिक्वायर्ड एज मच एज थ्री लेयर शीट. So he has used gold foil. So that is the particular which you have to justify within one mark. Now next, what are alpha particles? What are alpha particles? So you can write that doubly charged helium ion. They are categorized as alpha particles. They are always positively charged. Now, 9th question. That draw the schematic diagram for Thomson model. So we can easily draw by a circle. That circle is known as positive sphere. inside the randomly electrons are distributed with negatively charged. So that is so that is electrons.
And last question for today, student, that why when we'll talk about
why Thomson model is failed.
So only I'm explaining that limitations of Thomson model. He has said that in positively charged electrons are distributed randomly, but other scientists have proved that positively charged sphere is known as nucleus, and inside in the nucleus protons are there present, and outside of the nucleus electrons are revolving around the nucleus. So he was failed. He was not explained this particular statement which he has given by experiment. So that is all about today. In the next lecture, we are starting with the revision for the further chapters. Thank you, children, and have a nice day.